Now we shall see what are vectors and scalars. You have already learned the meaning of physical quantities. A physical quantity is a physical property, right? So it is a physical property that can be quantified, right? For example, if we have an object like this, we describe this object by its mass, and we say this object has a mass of 10 kg. So mass is a physical quantity which can be quantified, okay? And what does this 10 kg represents? 10 kg represents magnitude, right? In the same way, we say my height is 5 feet. When we say my height is 5 feet, what is the physical quantity? Physical quantity is height. And what is the magnitude of the height? 5 feet. So what does magnitude tells us? Magnitude tells us that how much of the physical quantities is. So again, to start with vectors and scalars, we need to go with physical quantity, its meaning, and the meaning of magnitude, right? So we have learned that in physics, physical quantity is a physical property that can be quantified, and we have, we have many physical quantities such as mass, distance, time, electric current, light intensity, and so on, right? Let us take an example. If we go to shop and ask a shopkeeper to give 10 kg rice, so what he does? He will weigh 10 kg rice in his balance, whatever may be the type of the balance he has, and then that he gives the rice, right? Now in this sentence, what is the physical quantity? Physical quantity is the mass. We describe rice with its physical quantity called mass here. And what is the magnitude of mass? Magnitude of mass is 10 kg, right? Someone buy 20 kg of rice. Now what is the change? Change is the magnitude. So in this example, magnitude of mass is 20 kg. So if I ask you what is the total of rice which is bought there in that shop, what we do? We add 10 kg plus 20 kg, right? And then we say it is 30 kg rice. It's a simple calculation, right? Suppose if we take a same type of example but with the physical quantity force, right? Then what is the difference of this physical quantity with the physical quantity called mass? We have already taken this physical quantity and discussed about this, and we came to know that this physical quantity can be expressed in kgs, and it can be quantified, and that is what it indicates magnitude. Right? And therefore we can say that mass always has magnitude. Right? When we say sugar, we have to say that how much sugar it is. Is it 1 kg or 2 kg? Any other magnitude we can express. Depends on how much of mass it is. Now let's say force. Let's take an object here. And if I say that there is a 10 newtons of force on this object, immediately you will ask me, in which direction? Right? So when we say force, and when we say only 10 newton of force, what did we express? We have expressed only magnitude of force. But that is not the complete meaning of force. We will not understand only 10 newton is given to us unless a direction of that force is told to us, right? So force has magnitude, but it has also the direction, right? Otherwise it has no meaning. If F is 10 newton here, in which direction it is applied? Because if you apply force of 10 newton in this direction or in this direction or in upward direction, both all these forces are different because their directions are different. Now I hope you have understood force is one such physical quantity which has two components, that is magnitude as well as direction. If I say force of 10 newton is applied, I have told only magnitude, but force has a magnitude as well as a direction. Let us understand with another example. Let me write mass on one side and force on another side. So here I write, you know, mass of 15 kg, okay, and then another one 20 kg, both are of same material, right? Now if you ask what is the total mass, we simply add and write 35 kg. It's simple calculation. Because mass is such a physical quantity which has got only magnitude. And when a physical quantity which has only magnitude is added, you can simply add it. Whereas suppose if an object is applied some force on one direction, let us say around 10 newton, and on the other direction at the same time 6 newton. Now suppose if someone asks you to add this force, you cannot add 10 newton plus 6 newton, right? And write the answer 16 newton. Since a force has magnitude as well as direction, in net calculation of the force, direction matters. So in this example, it should be 10 newton plus minus 6 newton. That is the total force, which is equal to 10 newton, right? Minus 6 newton is equal to 4 newton, but what is the direction? Direction is indicated by plus sign here. Okay, and the answer for this question is 4 newton in this direction. So it will go with 4 Newton force, right? Now suppose if I take the same example and make this 6 Newton, okay, and this one is 10 Newton. Now what is the net force? 6 Newton plus minus of 10 Newton. Why minus? Its direction is different, and that will give you minus 4 Newton. And what does minus 4 Newton mean? Minus 4 Newton means this will be moving in this direction with how much of force? 4 Newton. Direction is different. So whereas you see here, when you add only magnitude, its answer will be different. But we cannot add only magnitude in case of force, because force is such a quantity which has magnitude as well as direction. Now we have come to the stage to understand that there are some physical quantities which has only magnitude, and there are some physical quantities which has magnitude as well as direction. Right? If we take another example of a car moving in one direction for a distance of say 4 kilometers, and in another direction for a distance of 3 kilometers, and the total time taken is 0.2 hour. So why I have taken this example is it is easy to express here in kilometer per hour. So we are not expressing this in meter per second, which is the SI unit. So whatever is given, we'll use here the units in this example. And we know that the speed is one physical quantity which can be expressed total distance covered by total time taken. Please remember, speed is a physical quantity. Right? Just like a mass or a height. Right? So total distance covered divided by total time taken. And how much is the total distance covered? 4 plus 3 is equal to 7 divided by 2 hours. So 7 is in kilometers and 0.2 is in hours. And if you calculate, you will get 35 kilometer per hour. Have a pause of this video and go through the calculations. Right? The speed is 35 kilometer per hour. Right? Now suppose if you want to calculate the velocity, then if you want to calculate velocity, we need to have an equation for the velocity, and velocity is not distance divided by time taken in case of this example, because there is change in direction here. It was going in this direction and then it changed in this direction. So here the velocity will be equal to displacement divided by time. Now what is the displacement again? Displacement we have to find out. Displacement should be, if I write A, B and C, okay, so the shortest distance between the initial position and the final position, right? And how do we do that? What is the displacement? Displacement can be calculated by using the Pythagoras formula. AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square, and you get the answer AC is equal to 5 kilometer in this case. Now, if you want to find out the velocity, which is displacement divided by time, you get, 5 kilometer divided by total time, 0.2 hour, and that is equal to 25 kilometer per hour. And what is that 25 kilometer per hour? It's a velocity. Now, velocity is 25 kilometer per hour, but the speed is 35 kilometer per hour. So what is the difference? This has a magnitude as well as direction, whereas speed has only magnitude. Direction doesn't matter. So what is the direction of the velocity then here? Direction of the velocity is the direction of the displacement. Right? And therefore, we can conclude now, vectors are the physical quantities, physical quantities having magnitude, magnitude as well as direction. Now scalars, let me write here, scalars are the physical quantities having only magnitude. So please remember this definition and try to keep in your mind the meaning of this. Coming back to the physical quantity, let us conclude. A mass has only magnitude. So as distance and also time. And therefore, mass, distance and time can be called as scalar quantities. Why? Because they have only magnitude. We cannot say 10 kg of mass in a particular direction. We cannot say 10 meter of distance in south direction. We are not telling that. Okay. A time also is a scalar quantity. What about electric current? Electric current is a vector quantity because it has got a magnitude as well as magnitude. It is expressed in amperes. So we say 10 ampere current. And current has always a direction. Okay. Now, again, light intensity is a scalar quantity. Force, which has a magnitude as well as direction, it's a vector quantity. A speed is a scalar quantity, we have seen just now. And velocity is a vector quantity. If velocity is a vector quantity, then acceleration also is a vector quantity. Okay, so there are many other physical quantities we'll come across in this class, where we have to have a clear cut difference between the vectors and scalars, right? Thank you very much.